Hey guys, Brito's Gaming here. Welcome back to Motorsport Manager Road to Glory with our Predator Racing Group. Here we are for round number 9, Milan Grand Prix. Done practice and everything as usual. Gonna head straight into the race. We've got race trim and soft tyres for both. 15% car set. She's got the three purples and she's like 98%, I think, roughly. Driver strategy, flat stick as per usual. I did change the sponsor objective to 4th or above 800,000. So I know there is a bit of rain coming, so I'm hoping we can get a good start and get a little bit of rain. We may finish inside the top 4, so fingers crossed. So we'll be starting, I think, what, 5th and 7th or something? Yeah, 5th for Sophia and 8th for Chica. So head straight in, let's see how they go. 5 lights and they're out and we're off. Chica with another great start, then sort of gets held back a little bit. So we're in 6th and 7th at the moment. Got Buckle over just in front of Balcazar, and there goes Balcazar around the outside. Just made it stick. Buckle over's dropped back a little bit. Bump up the double speed now. Still 6th. Buckle over's back to 8th. Need Balcazar to keep pushing and try and get up the front, hopefully. She's got... Oh, Chu right behind. Chu's made the move down the inside. Now we're coming down the front straight. Haven't got the speed as the other cars have. She still holds on to P7, which is good, but Buckalova's dropping way back down to P10. Can't see any water at the moment, but I know there is going to be water coming eventually. So we'll triple speed it for now. The tyres are both fairly good. Everyone else is still running flat stick with everything. So we're 9th and 12th, so start didn't go according to plan. 10th and 13th now. Just need to keep these tyres reasonably fresh. Try not to push too hard. We'll put Balcazar back to high. Keep Buckalova going a little bit harder. Still no rain forecast yet. It might be towards the end of the race, which won't help us out at all. One of them has good wet weather running, so I think it's Chica. I'm not 100% sure. I can't remember. But so Balcazar still 10th. Buckalova is now back to 16th. So she's dropping back way too quick for my liking. Back to neutral tyres of both. Dropping back to high at the moment. So Balcazar, we're going to bump her up to overtake mode because now she's catching the cars ahead. Oop, safety car, so we're in. Still no wet weather, so we'll go another set of softs. Obviously fill her right to the top, only 9 laps. We're going to have her fast off 8 seconds. Buckalova is going to do the same. Safety car, so Chu crashed out from... where was he? P8, was he? No. I'm not sure where he was before he crashed. I think he did get ahead of us, didn't he? So yeah, Balcazar is now P8. Buckalova's 14th. Marchetta's crashed as well, actually. Unfortunately for him. Head back and have a look. Balcazar's in. Stacked too much. Not too bad. So she's out in 9th. 6th, actually. Bad stop with fuel for Buckalova. She's not going to be happy. She's back out in 15th. I think she lost a little bit of time. Now, low and low, and push for the tyres. Safety car's got 1 lap left. A few cars at the front didn't actually pit. Who didn't pit? Sevilla and Liao didn't pit. Not sure why you wouldn't. But alternate strategies, I guess. Still no rain on the radar. Did say we're going to get heavy rain for the race, so... not exactly sure if and when it's actually going to come, to be honest. So the safety car should be in the next lap. Fingers crossed. So you're coming in this lap, as I said. It's a long, long lap behind the safety car. Only halfway around the lap now. Still can't see any water on track at the moment. I'm hoping now that Balcazar can make the move and sort of try and get to the front, get at least get a couple of spots. The safety car's off, so put her on high and high. We're just going to put Buckle over on high. Still what, push with the tyres. There we go, it's green. She can't make a move into turn one. Oops, maybe she can. No, she can't. She's got Diaz going around the outside now, unfortunately. Dropped back to seventh. Here comes Cruz, the Garuda race team car. Flying around the outside. Drop her back to neutral with tyres for both of them because the tyres are going to get pretty bad, pretty quick, really hot. Now Balcazar's dropping back really quick, unfortunately. We're lucky to get a top 10, I think, the way it's going at the moment. So we've got Buckle over, she's right at the back of the pack, right down the back. Balcazar looks like she's holding everybody up, but as long as we stay in front, it's the main thing. Here comes, there's a little bit of water coming now, or very soon I should say. I don't know if it's going to be heavy or just intermediates to start with. Balcazar is in P8 now. Sibilan Liao pitted. Still going to just want to keep an eye on that wet weather, I think. Just drop back. No, she's held P8 now. Buckleover's back into P16. They're still pretty much at the back of the pack, except for the two guys that are pitted. She's got 3 laps left of fuel. Buckleover's got 3.6. Is anybody in the pits this lap? No one has yet. How many laps have we got to go? 10 laps to go. We haven't got enough with fuel anyway, so gonna push through, try and get her in next lap, not this lap now, so end of lap 13. But Balcazar's push dropped way back. It's back to 11th at the moment. There's nobody in the pits this lap, not yet, so we're gonna come in. Oh, there's a couple now. We're gonna come in, set of inters, fuel options fill us right to the top, parts are all good, you're off. The Buckleover's right behind as well. So I'm not sure if we'd let her stay out for another lap or we bring her in as well. Nobody's complained yet about being wet out there. We can't bring her in this lap because she'll get stacked too much, I think. So we'll bring her in next lap, set of inters. 7 laps to go, we'll fill her right to the top, and off she goes. Let's have a look at Balcazar now. She's 9th, 10th, oh, 12th at the moment, not great. She's going to push, she's got excess fuel, going to attack with the tyres. She's going to do the same with Buckleover. Hope she makes it to the pits. She's right out of fuel as she drives in. Buckleover comes back out, she's going to come back out in 16th. Balcazar is still P14, so we're not going to get that P4 that I was hoping for. It's a shame, because Milan was a pretty good track for us last season, just not great this season. Drop her back to high with fuel, because there's 6 laps to go, so she's going to be tight with fuel, I think, Balcazar. Should we pull in for a set of wets, or should we just continue to run to the end and hope the other guys ahead actually do pit? Back to push and push with their tyres, they're getting the optimal temperature range. There's 5 laps to go now. She's catching the car ahead this lap. The Buckleover is still P18, she's pretty much dead last. Sevilla's in the pits, comes back out in last spot. So I don't think his strategy's worked out well for him either. 11th, Arbeloa's going to pit as well, so is 12th. Maybe they're all going to come in for a set of wets, which we're not going to. We're just going to try and run to the end, because their pit stop is going to slow them down enough that hopefully we can gain a few spots. still running pretty hard. You drop it back to neutral with the tyres. Buckle over neutral as well. I don't know why she's running low fuel. Maybe I forgot to change it or I didn't click it properly. So Balcastar is still ninth. None of the cars ahead are pitted. They're all on inters. Actually, the cars behind went out on inters again too. So not sure why they pitted again, but it's handy for us. The Severe's back to 14th. Balcazar still up in P9. She's not doing too bad. We really want a top 8 so we can get some extra points here if we can. There's two laps to go. Gonna bump her up with attack with the tyres. Same with Bakalova. Try and get a few spots here at the end. She could make a few spots here. It's a final lap now for the leaders. There's one spot. Gonna bump her up to overtake mode. Let's see how she goes. Can she get Fisher as well? Diaz is not too far down the track as well. Come on, Balcazar. Go for P6 down the inside. Yeah, up into P7, I should say. P7. There's Diaz just ahead. So we may get 6th here, but I don't think we're going to get any higher than 6th with the other cars ahead. Here we go, P6. Buckle over to P12 now. So Balcazar's P6, she won't get any higher than this. Have to conserve her fuel now because she's nearly out. Hopefully she doesn't run out. She has, but she's made it home. Well done, P6 for Balcazar. So look at Sofia Bakalova, P12. So it's not too bad. Didn't finish as high as I would have liked. It's going for P4. We're only a couple off it. Still a decent result for Balcazar. Sofia didn't do overly well, but Can't complain at all. So we only did two stops. A couple of cars around us behind us did three stops. That really hurt them, I think. Sevilla did three stops, and that was a silly, I think. They really should have come pitted in here as well. So four laps and five laps on inters, I'm not sure what the go is there. So low chance of rule breaking, didn't get caught again. Ooh, Eduardo got caught. Two spots, unfortunately. There wasn't no one else above her as well. So we have P5 and P12 now. So it's an even better result for Chica. She's now 9th in the championship. Sophia has dropped back to 17th, though she's not going to get 13th unless she gets a great result the last race. We'll see the last race. As we know, it's double points. So if we can get a good result for both of our drivers, then there's a chance we can bump up the standings a little bit. Everything's improving in the green, which is great. Nearly 100% for relationship there. Came 5th, so everyone's happy, plus 1 marketability. It's great news. We lost money because we didn't take the 10th or higher. We took the risk to go for 4th or higher and just didn't get there. Well, one spot we missed out. So male car condition was pretty good. Nothing else to worry about. Car repairs done. There's nothing else we can do. Scouting. He's not scouting anyone at the moment. We scouted all the younger guys that aren't with a team. Capel Canty, he's got a team. Molly Fox. Should be one to get, I think. It's pretty good. Nikolai Surikov. Be another one to get. That's awesome. And Aki Lippinen. We need to get a lot higher, obviously, before we could even think about going there. We're just going to scout drivers because we might as well. Oops. Might as well just pretty much scout everybody. So the scout's got something to do. Oops, keep pressing the wrong bloody button. Scout all the younger guys. I don't want anyone older than 28, that's for sure. But the drivers we've got now, I think we're pretty much going to try and stick with for as long as we can. But continue on through. So we've got the last race, the Black Sea Grand Prix. It's So double points. We need a bit more money in the bank to try and get a better car for next season and start designing parts straight away. And so Sophia fancies a teammate. Okay. Two girls, but anyway. Nothing wrong with that, obviously. Yeah, so we want to try and do a little bit better than I did this season. I just sort of didn't do the right stuff at the start of the season. We didn't have a lot of money in the bank to be able to do things, so really need to make a better effort for the next season. So we're going to go 10th or above, not changing any parts, head straight in. So I'll do what I usually do, get stuck in, do the practice, and we'll come back when we're ready to race round 10 for the Black Sea Grand Prix in Russia. So we'll see you again soon. Alright guys, welcome back to round number 10, the Black Sea Grand Prix from Russia. So, going through practice, 13th and 14th in practice, race trim and pit stop legend there for Chika, soft tyres and race trim for Sophia, car set, they're both 97%, both going to start with 11 laps, but I'm going to put Chika on a medium tyre to start with and see how she goes, and Sophia on a soft, driver strategy, both flat stick to start with, also going for 10th or above this time. I don't think we're getting any rain this race, but I guess we'll have to wait and see. So head straight in. So Sophia's P14 and Chica's P12. So Chica's going to have a tough sort of race, I think. I have to turn around the other way so we can see the start. So Chica wasn't too bad a start. Sophia is up into P3. Let's go and have a look at her. She's going pretty good. We've got double speed to start with. Balcazar's P11. Bakalova's P3. There you go. Bakalova's up to P2 now. Can she get ahead of Diaz as well and get up into P1? That's the question. Balcazar still 12th. We've got Varnada now coming through on Bakalova. So she's dropped back down to P3. Righto. Triple speed. Bakalova needs to put her head back down now and start getting some consistent laps in. She's in P3, decent gap to the car behind. Go back and have a look at Balcazar. She's back to P12. She's not doing too bad. I think most of the cars behind us are on mediums. Cars ahead are all on softs except for one. Just let Dreyfus through, then got the spot back. She has an Arbeloa's going around as well. We've got Sevilla making his way through as well. So now Balcazar is back to P14. She's battling away. She's doing a good job, but she's just not really making any moves and any ground up to get towards the front. She really need to buckle over. If she can get a great result here, she might make her top 13 spot. She's now up into P2. She's right on the back of Diaz as well. She's still pushing hard. Both girls are pushing fairly hard. Have we got buckle over? She's going to try and make the move for P1 now. Down the inside. Couldn't make it stick. She's dropped back a little bit. But she goes back down the inside. Still can't make it stick. Drop back to push for the tyres. She's now dropped back to third. Push for Balcazar as well. It's 22 laps to go. She's just locked up as well. It's not going to help. The tyres aren't the greatest at the moment because she's locked up again. Vanden's taken off in the lead. We've got to get ahead of Diaz. Diaz looks like she's holding us up a fair bit. We'll drop back to P4. Nope, held P3. Balcazar has dropped way back. P18 now. Come on, buckle over. We're all wrestling you now. Need to get these spots. She's still up the front. Oh, we have to straight in the pits. No water on track. Go for another set of softs. Fill the ride up with fuel. Parts are all good. We're going to go for a fast stop. Balcazar's going to come in too. Put a set of softs on this time. All the same stuff. Let's have a look at Bakalova. See if she can get in there fairly quick and get out ahead of everybody. That'll be great if she can. Turn the camera around so we can have a look. So they're all in. Oh, she's going to be close. P2, I think. Yeah, she's back into P2. Well, maybe she's in first. I don't know. So dropping both back to low. and low. So we're now 1st and 12th. Hopefully that's correct. Hopefully we're not going to get pinged and lose the spots. So try and conserve fuel now. We've got 15 laps to go. 15 laps to go. I think, no, not counting right. 18 or 19 laps to go. So Sophia's up in a P1, which is great. As I said, ripper job by her. Fairly lucky. 19 laps to go. There we go. Fairly lucky for her to actually come out in front there. She just needs to hold on to the spot now, if she can. So we're the only ones that are on pushing with our tyres. So we'll drop it back down. Everyone else has pitted once, except Sevilla, who's actually crashed out. She cruises pitted twice now, so the Garuda team is going to be last and second last at the moment. Not be happy with that. Last round of the season. If they don't get a good result here, they might drop way back down. So bump them up both now to high and attack, overtake. Need to get a ripper start here for Bakalova. She's made a massive gap there. She's done a great job. Over a second, she pulled away there on the restart. Balcazar's back down to P13. Bakalova needs to just keep pushing and try and keep this first spot. Balcazar 15th now. She's still dropping back. The Bakalova still got Gerard right behind. She gets away a little bit down the straight and then loses it, breaking into turn one. Have a look. No rain on the radar. Chica's locking up. So there goes her tyres. I think Balcazar locked up. Well, sorry, Bakalova backed up, as locked up as well. 71%. For Bakalova, Balcazar's down to 62% for her tyres. So they're wearing pretty quick. And Bakalova's, unfortunately, now she dropped back to P2. We've got Vanen and Milo behind. Tyres aren't the greatest. Dropping back to push. We can't afford to burn them out too quick. We can't pin any earlier than lap 15 or 16, so we need like at least another 5 laps out of both of these guys, if we can. So bump them both to high. So Balcazar's up into P12 now. She's doing pretty good. A couple of spots back. Liao, Cruz, and Cavalcanti all pitted. Gerard's taken off, absolutely taken off. She's 3.5 seconds ahead. So Bakalova's still P2. Balcazar's still P12. She's got Chu right behind her as well. Go back and have a look. When Bakalova, I think she's going to lose that spot. See, Dreyfus has got issues with her car just ahead. Back a look at Bakalova, who's out the front. P number 2. Still got Vanen right behind. Bakalova's tyre wear is absolutely shot. Go for a set of mediums. 12 laps to go. So I don't think she's going to make it. Might drop her back to medium and high, see if we can save enough fuel for her to get to the end without having a pit again. Bakalova's tyres are absolutely shot as well. She needs to really just needs to push hard now. I'm going to slow it right down. Has Gerard pitted? No, he hasn't. We might just keep going through and bring her in next lap. Set of mediums to get her to the finish. There'll be 12 laps to go once she pits. We want 11 laps in the tank. Just drop back to P3 now. Drop her back to conserve with the tyres, because we wanted to make it back without blowing those tyres if we can. She's pushing hard. She's doing well. She's still P3. We just needed to have a quick stop. Put Balcazar back to push for the tyres. Bakalova is in. We have a quick stop, guys. Come on. Yep, 11.2 seconds. That's pretty good. Drop it back to low and attack. So we are now 13th and 17th. We've got Valdez behind Bakalova. Fresh set of tyres as well. Well, it's same, running the exact same strategy we are at the moment. 10 laps to go, still can't see any water on track at the moment. There goes Buckle over up into P6. Still two cars ahead that haven't pitted. You got Lau and Marchetta. Marchetta's tyres are absolutely shot. We've got Sabato right behind Buckleova now. She needs to try and keep this spot for the rest of the race, but she's not. She's dropped back a little bit, so back bit down to P7. 9 laps to go. She's got a little bit of excess fuel, but not much, so we need to sort of try and conserve her fuel at the moment. All the cars around are running extremely hard. So hopefully we can get these spots back later in the race. We're back to push for the tyres. She's still P7, which is, she's doing okay. Balcazar's back to P15, so she's not having another great race. She might bump up to 14th here with Cruz in the pits. She has. Buckleova's lost another spot, back down to P8 now. She's got 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th right behind her as well. Just need to stay inside this top 10. Everyone around us is running hard. We can't afford to go running hard just yet. There goes El Sadat down the inside of Buckleova. She's now back to P8. We have to try and bump her up with the fuel. I think Balcazar, we're going to have to put her on low because she still hasn't got excess fuel in the tank. Buckleova is now just dropping back quick. Back down to P10. She's down to P11 soon when Diaz goes around. Back down to P11. It's not going to be a great race for us. We needed to get up inside the top 8 at least. Even higher, hopefully. I don't think it's going to happen. Really, really, really need a top 10 just for that extra money. So Balcazar's P14 still. She's still trying to conserve fuel. It's 5 laps to go. She's got 4.2 in the tank, so she may not make it. She's going to go close. So Buckleova's now up to P9 with a couple of guys in the pits. It's going to help us a fair bit. She's still got a little bit of excess fuel on board. Balcazar still going to try and limp it home from here, I hope. So Buckleova's keeping up with the cars ahead. We're all pretty much doing the similar stuff. Bump back to push for the tyres because they're cooling down a little bit. The Diaz, also that their tyres are shot. Or not shot, but worse than ours, probably about 30%. Now they're at 46. So hopefully we've got enough in these tyres to make it to the end. 3 laps to go. She's got 3.6 in the tank. Balcazar's got 2.5, so she might go close. I'm going to bump her up with high with the fuel for Buckleova. She's up in a P7. Antonov's got a fresh set of softs though, so she'll probably come tearing through in a minute. So Buckleova's trying to make a move on Diaz here. Just can't get through. There she goes down the inside. Can she hold it up into P6? 2 laps to go. Bump her up to overtake mode. There goes Antonov, we thought, with the soft tyres. Here comes Lau as well, right behind. Trying to hold that spot. She has Buckleova's P7 now. I don't think Balcazar's going to make it with fuel and tyres, but she's dead last anyway, so it doesn't matter. Buckleova now P8, so we're going to put her on attack for the last lap. She needs to push as hard as she can. Need to keep this 8th spot, if not gain a little bit extra. Back to high with the fuel, because I know she was very, very, very close. Her tyres are absolutely shot now, so she might drop back now because she locked up again. She's still trying to hold off Liao there. She needs to hold her off down into the last corner she has. So, but she's out of fuel. She's dropped back to 10th. Damn. Just too close for fuel there. Just pushed a little bit too hard too early, I think. So, and Balcazar comes home in dead last. So that didn't help her at all. So not a great end of the season, unfortunately. Pretty disappointing, really. We should have had some points there. At least it made the top 10, which is good for our money, but not much else. So I think we just pushed it a little bit too far on tyres at the end there. We should have got 14 laps out of them, but Balcazar pushed for 13 laps with hers. Sorry, just closed out of the wrong thing. There we go. Continue on. See if anybody got caught cheating, hopefully. Gain a couple of extra spots. Hopefully not us. No, good. No, no one got caught. Oh, they got caught. Four places for Milo. Two drive-throughs for Felisandro, and she still finished that high. Park was RP19. Sophia, P10. So Chica finishes 12th overall. Sophia, 17th. So she didn't get a 13th, unfortunately. We finished 8th, which is where we wanted to finish. Where we said we would finish. So they should be happy with that, I hope. Not ideal, though. We wanted to finish a lot higher than that. It was looking good early on in the season, but just sort of died off at the end there. So everyone should improve, I hope. Chica, not so much. Actually, neither did Sophia, to be honest. Finished 8th overall. Everyone's happy. Nearly 5 mil in the bank, end of the season. Plus, we're going to get a little bit more. So, Alessandro Cruz is the world champion for Garuda Race Team. Sophie Sevilla finished 2nd. That's a Garuda 1-2, so good for them. Look at Mail. None of that, we don't care. Contract's running down for Chica. Ooh, Kyle Goslin. So, staff. Can we renew contract? Interested? I prefer a long contract with good. Bonus size isn't very important. We had 90,000 for 3rd or above. We'll do the same. Continue. Drivers. So Chica has only got 1 month left in the contract. So 623 is what she was getting paid. 623. Give her 631. Is fairly. So this is fairly important. Make you number one or equal status. Equal status. Short contract. I'm going to go 36 months and just see what she says. So I'm going to go 3rd or above. Going to give it 90,000. Continue. Hopefully she's happy with that. So car repair complete, which is great. Championship promotion. Promise broken. Minus 50 morale for 5 weeks. Well, it's not my fault you didn't drive fast enough, unfortunately. So we've made 11.8 million prize money. Manager of the season went to me. Oh, awesome. I don't know why, but thank you very much. Driver of the season was Lisandro Cruz, of course. He absolutely killed everybody this season. Rules are now active. So now we've got Vancouver. Points for the top 10. We'll change to the Cortez tyres. So by Esperanca, went to the World Motorsport Championship. Milan Racing dropped back. Garuda have been promoted, and Zampelli Engineering has dropped down. So we'll do the pre-season for the next season at the end of this video. Might as well just whack it on the end. So he's accepted. So we'll sign that. Thank you. Mail. She's accepted as well, so we'll sign her. So now she's got 37 months and Sophia's only got 13 months. Can we try and renew her as well? She's not interested. Okay, my bad. Got a few sponsors there, but we'll leave them and wait, I think, till the start of the season, just to make sure we're not gonna, we might get some better offers, I think. So 1 million up front, 180,000 per race. 400,000, 150 per race. So we've got another sponsor offer. So Barnaby White was scouted. It was actually not too bad. Focus is down a little bit, but it's not bad. We've only got 5.5 million for next year's car, which isn't much. Okay, so what do we need to do here? So Improvability is medium, and fuel efficiency is weak, but that's very weak and medium, but the base stat's higher. So we want to keep the improvability higher. So fuel is medium and very weak improvability, or weak and weak. It's like, what do we do there? Like, do we? Hasn't got much improvability. But I think if we do medium fuel efficiency, that may be better, because we're going to design some new parts, which hopefully we'll be able to this season, some more than we did last season. Might be a little bit better. So, tyre wear weak and weak. There's not much difference between weak and weak and medium and very weak. Probably better for the average for the medium, weak and weak, I think. So, the brakes got very weak and very weak, which we don't want. Very weak and weak. Weak and medium. So I think we'll just have to spend the money. So 13.3 mil. Confirm. So it's not too bad. So we've got 9 mil in the bank. Who do we scout? Barnaby White. We've already checked that out. We've got another sponsor offer. So 300,000 per race, which is good. It'll be 3.9 mil. This one will be probably nowhere near as much. 2.6 mil, roughly. Yeah, that one's not as much either, so that one's probably the best. But we don't get an upfront payment, which isn't too big an issue, I don't think. Continue on through to scouting people. We can't do anything with our cars yet, which is good. She's feeling blue. Doesn't matter. So scout, we got three new ones. So we've got Daisy Parker. She's not great. Bao Tang, not good. Ivona Fonseca, if her smoothness was much better, she'd be a much better driver. She's not too bad, but so another couple of sponsors. So now it's time to have a look. So 12th or above, 250. 11th or above, 300,000. 150,000. That is absolutely shocking. I think we just need to go with Duce. We won't do it now. We'll leave it till later on. Continue through. Tyre simulations. We will do that. Have a look. So where's our tyre wear now? It's 2 and a bit. So if we go, sounds good. Should be 3 and a bit. Awesome. Skipping through, still got our car designing. Taking forever. Holipa scout reports done. New driver signings and stuff, which we don't really care about. So fuel efficiency plus one. So where are we now? We're 1 1/3, I guess. More money down the drain. Well, not really. But so now we've got 3 1/3, which is awesome for us. Few new drivers, they're not good either. Very good. Favorite her, just in case. She's a slacker. Is that that's a permanent trait? Yeah. She's a nice girl. She races snowmobiles, which is good. So she's actually very good. A little bit old, 20 or not old, 25 is not too bad, but for racing terms, she's a little bit old. So Ryan's no good. Continue through. Nothing new. Here comes our livery edit. So don't worry about all this stuff. Let's get reports finished on Sabaloa. Should we do a race against him? We were, I think. We should still, yeah, we still will actually. So we're going to do our edit their car livery. Haven't really looked at anything at this point in time, but I did have an idea just to go black and the red and just find something that fits. So 9, 8, 7, 6, 4, 3. 4 is not too bad. So 3, 2, and 1. I think 7 or 4. I like the idea of 7. We should just stay still so we can have a good look. Not really liking any of these at the moment. The 7 or 4? I think we'll go for 7. That'll do. So full black and we just got a little bit of white there. Is that a better colour? No, not really. Actually, that's probably better. There we go. So that'll do for us, I think. So black, red, red and black. Livery number 7. Continue. So that's our car for season number 3. We're still designing. Scouting again, which was up below, which we don't care about. We already know. Continue through. Plus 1 to tyre heating. Which, yes, we will. 2.5 mil. So we're still losing money. So more mail. Pre-season testing this weekend. Scout reports finished on Simone Santore. Oh, not great. Plenty of possibility there, but no, not great at the moment. Our car is still not good. 10th overall. So the new car's been completed. So pre-season testing. We'll go into the testing and see how we go. The chickas out there, they're both out now. They aren't complaining about anything yet. Oh, chicken's got an oil leak, which isn't good. Buckle over's P6 at the moment, which is fairly good. P5 even, so 5th and 14th. Both pretty happy. Which is great news for us. Making sure they're both happy, but want the car to perform well as well. Still got the worst car, so now we need to go into our improved parts. Flat out reliability is what we want to do. So we want to do engine... and gearbox to start with. Round number 2, what will they like? They want to accept like a gearbox or suspension. So design new parts. Go for a new gearbox, I think. So we can go for that one, 80 and 114. Or 65 and 99. Has got risk level though, which I'm not too concerned about one risk level. It's when you start doing one or two that comes an issue. So we'll build that. Get that done. Pre-season testing report went brilliantly. Targets. I think we're going to go for 6th or above. We really should be able to do better than last season. Obviously, we need the money too. So sponsor offer. What do we do here? So 300,000 up front with 250,000 payment for 6 races. If we make them all, that'll be 1.5, 1.8 million. If we do that, it'll be 1.8 million as well. So they're exactly the same, just we get upfront payment here. So we'll take that one. Just for the upfront cash in case we don't make one. Now for this, so 300,000 for 13 races. I'll quickly calculate this because I just want to make sure we're doing the right thing. So 300,000 times 13 is 3.9 mil. Or we've got 180 times 8, 1.44 mil, so 2.5 mil pretty much. So this one's, Kashima's definitely way better for us. Okay, so at this point in time, we're just improving parts. Black Sea Grand Prix is in 11 days. So we need to come back. Now, look at our parts. What else do we need that's really low? So suspension's fairly low. Everything's fairly low at the moment, so take these off. Those ones and these ones and try and get them bumped up to around about 50% for the start of the race, hopefully. So scout report for Smith and Stramble. He's fairly good actually, Ollie Clark Smith. Nikolai Strambi. This is also fairly good. Still happy with our drivers, but both our drivers are fairly good. So Bakalova's going to start last, the first race, and Chica's going to start fifth, so that's going to suck for us. So we're going to travel now, so we're going to look at the car. The gearbox is going to be made the next day. Everything's at 50% at the moment. We need to go to fit parts. So Sophia is angry for some reason, so Chica, we want her to have the best of everything, which she has got at the moment. Wow, 109 to 61 for suspension, that's good. Sophia is not happy. We want to make sure, for Chica, we want to improve all her parts first, I think. Try and bump hers up, because she's going to be our number one driver, I'm thinking. I know that Sophia is a little bit better, like, in the long run, but I think Chica's just performed really well. So back to home, go to continue. So we're not going to go into the race, so we'll come back for obviously season 3, episode number 1. Heavy range of practice and races clear. The Black Sea Grand Prix from Russia. 11 races this season. As we know, we've got Canada for race number 11, which will be exciting. So yeah, it's been Predators Gaming. Thanks for watching our season 2. Of Motorsport Manager Road to Glory with the Predator Racing Group. Don't forget to smash the like button, put down a comment, and let me know how you think we're going to go this season, any predictions, that sort of stuff. And haven't subscribed already, hit the subscribe button as well to follow this series and other things we've got going on. But thanks for watching, and we'll see you again for the start of season number 3.